Hi everyone, and welcome to this video course in Introductory Statistical Mechanics. This is an introductory video in which I'll tell you briefly about what statistical mechanics is all about and what I will present in the rest of the course. I hope that you'll find it interesting. I will assume previous knowledge of basic thermodynamics and classical mechanics, which are needed to understand this topic, and I might cite a little bit of quantum mechanics here and there, but I will try to explain every concept without using maths if I can do so without oversimplifying. Statistical mechanics is a physical theory with a massive number of diverse applications. It was originally developed to study ordinary gases, but eventually has been applied to many other things, like metals, or waters, or circuits, to the understanding of the star cores, and is recently even been applied to the motion of crowds of people, and to economics, and to finance. Without it, our understanding of the world and our technology would definitely be much behind. It was originally studied to provide a somewhat rigorous foundation to thermodynamics, deriving it from classical mechanics. The problem with thermodynamics is that its foundations are far from rigorous. The three laws of thermodynamics, together with the definition of thermal equilibrium, can actually be used to predict the behavior of gases at equilibrium in many different conditions. But where do they come from? How does the behavior of a gas relate to one of its particles? In statistical mechanics, the thermodynamic properties of a gas, like its total energy, which we can denote with the letter E, its volume, V, its pressure, P, and so on, can all be expressed in terms of averages of the energy function of the gas, which we denote with the letter H, to differentiate it from the energy of the gas, which is E, and which is a function of all the positions Q and all the momentums P of all the particles of our gas. These averages will be defined differently depending on how we choose to set our system. If our gas is completely isolated in an insulated box, then the system's total energy will be conserved, together with its volume and with its number of particles. In this case, we will call this average microcanonical. All its other properties, like the pressure, the temperature, etc., will then be determined by these three pieces of information of the state of the gas. A different, somewhat more typical case is the one in which we fix the temperature of our box by putting it in contact with a source of heat. This way, we fix its temperature, rather than its total energy, E, and we keep fixing the volume and the number of particles. This is what we will call the canonical average. In even other cases, we might not have a fixed number of particles. For example, say that instead of studying a gas in a canister, we are studying the air in a non-airtight room. Particles will fly in and out of the room all the time, and their number will vary continuously. In this case, we remove n from the list of the thermodynamic variables, and we replace it with something else, which we call the chemical potential, and we denote by the Greek letter mu. This is the energy that is required to add a particle to the gas, and it turns out to be a convenient choice in many cases. When we fix T, mu, and V, we will be in the grand canonical ensemble, and the average will be the grand canonical average. The course will be devoted to the derivation and to the explanation of these averages, as well as showing a few applications and exercises. Furthermore, since there is no sign of these different averages in standard thermodynamics, I will also show that they are all equivalent in macroscopic systems. That is, every time we consider something big enough to be seen or touched, or even slightly smaller, we want all these averages to give us the same answer.